Hi everybody. So I'm a member of the Goal Getters Club led by my Habibi Carmen, and she's the author of the Art of Goal Getting book, which I really recommend you to check out. So we are on a 7-day confidence challenge, and it was very interesting, so that's why I wanted to share it with you. So one of her first questions is, what does confidence mean to you? And basically, in which area would you like to improve your confidence? And, you know, and what would it, you know, what would it take? You know, what would improve if you had confidence? And really, I started to think about, you know, this whole area that I've been working on lately, which is really to not let anything outside of me determine my value, determine my happiness, determine my meaning and purpose. Understanding that nothing outside of me can give me anything. Not a relationship, not a job, not success, not money, not other people telling me something. That ultimately it's really about what I believe about myself and what I believe I'm lacking, and what, you know, what these other things actually need to mean to me, so that I feel, you know, all these things that I don't feel coming from inside. So having, you know, understood that was like such a big thing in my development, and having, you know, seen that this is like a huge piece of development for a lot of people, I really started seeing confidence in a very different way. And this is, of course, also very much influenced by how Dr. Joe Dispenza has been, you know, influencing me in the way that he's teaching, you know, how we have to break the habit of ourselves. And, you know, as a collective, we have put a lot of meaning into achieving things, external things to actually help us achieve self-esteem. And I think basically having attended the last, you know, week-long in Mallorca in April 2019, I really realized that, you know, self-esteem can actually come from the moment-of-moment overcoming ourselves. Basically, the habits that are painful, the habits that are limiting ourselves, the beliefs that are limiting ourselves. Very often, we delay these moments of victory until we achieve something, and this makes our lives so difficult. We actually have to go to a new perspective of victories is... A victory is when we moment by moment conquer ourselves. In the moment of us, you know, noticing a limiting thought, that we just decide, I'm not going to go there anymore. Is this loving to me to believe this thought, and to not give it too much attention, and also not to beat ourselves up for it. In the moment that, you know, we are seduced into, you know, some kind of, you know, procrastinating thought, or some kind of self-limiting or self-dishonoring behavior, that we say, you know what, is this loving to me? And to really understand that, you know, there's nothing that anybody can give us and do to us if we decide that we're going to be loving to ourselves. And yeah, so this has been really life-changing to me, to really understand that victory can be defined in the moment, and that, you know, we don't have to wait until we achieve all these milestones, which is always celebrated in our cultures, and where we are always delaying, you know, the satisfaction and the feeling of well-being that we can have just by, you know, experiencing from moment to moment how we are conquering ourselves, how we are overcoming ourselves, and sometimes also making peace with the parts of ourselves that may be limiting, that may be painful, that may not be ideal for us. And so, yeah, I'm going to complete this 7-day confidence boost challenge, because I think this will be a game changer for me again, and it's really in alignment with what I've been doing. And if you have any thoughts about this, if you really want to know more or anything, you know, feel free to private message me. And I'll definitely be able to, you know, teach more about this. I'm very inspired by this subject. Okay, lots of love, everybody. Bye-bye.